anime thighs. When she opened up so wide, I got a twinkle in my eye. Pussy is so tight, I just really want a pipe. Oh my gosh, she got them big ass titties, she's only... Anime thighs, when she opened up so wide, I got a twinkle in my eye. Pussy is so tight, I just really want a pipe. Oh my gosh, she got them big ass titties, she's only...
Bitch, I'm about to fuck this cutie, so I whip out my katana and I knock this little bitch out with just one hit like I'm Saitama. Why you act like I'm just starting? Like, little bitch, I don't want drama. I'm still fly when she say no, call me Shigeo Kageyama, ayy. Sword fighting with my penis like I'm in a fucking dojo. All these bitches want me like my name was fucking JoJo. Damn, my penis is too tiny like it was a no-show. Bitch, don't watch your coochie, watch anime with the bros, though.
Seal them with my motherfucking bitch. I might pull up, give those thighs a little motherfucking kiss. And man, if you talking shit, tell Ryuk you on a list. Yeah, your sister is my groupie, she take this anime dick. Okay, like little bitch, I don't care if that fat ass is 2D. Score a bounty on that pussy, you can call me Spike Lee. Putting out fire, getting ice, bitch, I'm Todoroki. And if you got some shit to say, then you can say it to me.
Anime thighs, when she opened up so wide, I got a twinkle in my eye. Pussy is so tight, I just really want a pipe. Oh my gosh, she got them big ass titties, she's only... Anime thighs, when she opened up so wide, I got a twinkle in my eye. Pussy is so tight, I just really want a pipe. Oh my gosh, she got them big ass titties, she's only...
Asuna, Asuna, Mikasa, please, can you just give me head? Please just get on your knees, bitch. I'll beat up that ass like my name is Bruce Lee, and I'll eat up that pussy like I'm Kaneki. Ayy, all these people rhyming, are they even trying? I be buying all this hentai, so I jerk it, I'm not lying. Now I'm sighing, cause I want Hatsune Miku, now I'm crying. When I fuck anime bitches, I'll be moaning and be whining. Ayy, thick thighs look sexy, even when especially she decides to wear her dress. Ooh, nuzzles on my neck, now we laying on the bed. Man, I love my body pillow, especially giving head. You know what's next.
Anime thighs, when she opened up so wide, I got a twinkle in my eye. Pussy is so tight, I just really want a pipe. Oh my gosh, she got them big ass titties, she's only...
Hey girl, I gotta know, do you got games on your phone? Why don't you just come over? I don't wanna play them alone. Hey bitch, tell me which game is your favorite. Play Super Smash, I'll be famous. Or you play Legend of Zelda, whatever is better for you, we can play it. Gaming on my new PlayStation that I got from MC Weijin. Baby, I'm sorry though, I don't got Mario. We can play Pokemon, just got Lucario. I don't need audio, just need the sound of your voice. I can't make a choice. How about say fuck it, we don't need to play any games. Wanna touch your body though, I wanna be Sonic. You could be Amy Rose, girl, I wanna show you off. Don't want you to leave, but before you go, I gotta know. Hey, girl, I gotta know, do you got games on your phone? Why don't you just come over? I don't wanna play them alone.
Okay guys, what's up? I know I've been doing these morning streams a lot because I'm like, let me just start streaming in the morning before I go to work. And I'm gonna start bike riding. Oh, the shit's working. Yes. But that's the gist of it. I'm gonna be streaming in the mornings right before I go to work just so I could at least get some streams in. It's a good time for us Europes. Also, shout outs, GG's, new flavor. Yo, I shit you not, this is like my top two flavor right now. You know what? This might be like the best flavor next to Mango Meta and Blue Raz. You said it's a bad time for us Americans?
Virginity, no more talking about 2 year olds and give me taking their virginity. like, if you think that you gotta be kidding me, I'll be spitting that shit. I'm willingly
the chat.
I'm dealing with these feelings.
There we go.
Come from the ceiling. I feel a rush in my body. I'm sorry. You want to meet her? I'm about some shit like fucking your mommy or a baby. But I guess that I'm just not on it lately. I'm just working on my own shit. Got a fucking problem. You can come and suck my own.
At your mom's house so much. Getting homesick. Let's see what's happening on Twitter. Because, let's see if there's anything we could talk about. Tony says, people are mad Taskmaster was treated dirty in Black Widow. He is a cool villain and is and an interesting villain, only to be done lazily. Taskmaster gets more depth and character development in the side mission of Spider-Man 4 than in the entire runtime of Widow. No, that's what I was saying. I was like, did they really make him, like, lame as fuck? Because I remember in Spider-Man 4, Miles Morales, like, this guy... I said Spider-Man 4, Miles Morales. You know, Spider-Man, Marvel Spider-Man, the video game on PlayStation. He was a fucking hard-ass character. And like, his whole concept was weird and stupid. So, the fact that they did him kind of dirty in this movie... I don't know, man. Maybe did people feel like it was like some woman power agenda? Because I'm not gonna lie, Marvel started slowly doing that, like towards the end of the movie, where they would just have like a bunch of unnecessary scenes of girl power, and then you're just like, you kind of just give this face of cringe of just like you didn't need to do that. You could have just, you know. I don't know, man. He said that's how weirdos try to promote it. You said the marketing team tried to do that? Bro, I remember in Avengers Endgame. Remember the scene in Avengers Endgame when T'Challa or Black Panther comes out the portal and then they all start fighting, and then there was a scene where it was just all the girls popped up. Yo, everybody in the theater, I was in a packed theater. When that part happened, everyone was just like y'all didn't need to do that. But I guess y'all wanted to do that, so like, that part, I feel like, was a little unnecessary, but I was just like, I just let it roll. I was like, I don't give a fuck. But I remember people in the chat were like, not in the chat, but people in the theater were like, like, they didn't like that shit at all. They were like, what the fuck was this shit? You didn't need to do that. It's kind of hard to care about Black Widow when all we know, yes! That's another thing. We know she dies in the fucking Endgame movie. So why the fuck are we getting a film about her now? Shouldn't this film have came out before the shit that happens now? You said, I remember in the theater somebody saying, oh, brother. Yo.
Early stream, my boy.
Yo, thank you. Nova Moon with the resub. I don't know, man. The Marvel What If trailer is out and it's pretty good. It's because they just found the script during the COVID cleanup. Damn. They need to keep the actor relevant. Y'all, we heading over to anime, Matsuri in Houston. We're going to spend $1,000. Shit. Stay safe when you go over there, man. Thank you, Stardust Bay, for the info. But you said, if you're going to spend $1,000, wait, you live in Texas though, right? Because it's Matsuri in Houston. Try to get a bunch of anime figures or something, but don't overget too much shit. I miss anime cons. Facts. Oh my God. So I guess they kind of killed this character. History of Taskmaster. Nah, how long is this? My time is limited. 11 minutes. People are being racist. Excitement quickly turned to hurt when Lacey Mosley became the target of racist viewers shortly after the announcement of her casting in the iCarly revival this spring. They must have been like, where's Sam? Who the fuck is this? Damn, people really be getting mad. The iCarly fans were racist the whole time. What the hell? They're like, where's Sam? Where's the butter sock? Genshin Impact reveals 9 Inazuma characters. I'm gonna be real with you. I don't give a flying fuck about Genshin. Especially after I spent $100 on the game's release and they gave me a green kid and a shitty bow and arrow. So fuck that game. No joke, I would have felt much better if I spent that $100 and they at least gave me like 2 5-star units, right? If they gave me like 2 or 3 5-star units out of spending $100, I'd have been like, you know what? This game ain't so bad. But the amount of dirtiness that they did to me during that live stream when I spent $100 and I got Venti, which everyone's saying he's still a good unit, and a fucking bow and arrow, that shit grinded my gears. And I'm like, I'll never throw money in this shit again. You said Venti busted still. No, I hear that. A lot of people say Venti's still one of the best characters in the game. But what's stupid is the pull rates are such ass in that fucking game. And then in order to get the full benefit of Venti, you need to get him more times so you could unlock the constellations. Because you could have a regular Venti. Okay, that's great. But you need like a fully unbound Venti, which... I ain't doing all that shit.
Hey, okay, like back in 2010, bitch, I was only like 7. I started playing on the craft back in 2011. Got Flappy Bird up on my phone, bitch, I was chilling in heaven. And silly bands up on my wrist, I didn't know I was heading. Look at my phone, Pokemon Go, just found a Pikachu right on the floor. Adventure Time poster that's right on my door, pillow pet on my bed, and I say give me more. Think about cereal on the Saturdays, and the Legos that I'm just about to make. Or the times that I play Mario Kart on my DS, cause I had so much time to waste. And now it's just different, think of those times and it just got me missing. When I got Halo or Con for the Christmas, or on my forehead at night I get kisses. Damn, now it's just different.
I'm muted! Like I was saying, you said that I never played a gacha game, right? Here's the thing. I've played gacha games before. And I've played a gacha game called Dragalia Lost, which is one of the most generous gacha games I've ever played. Bro, they give you 5 stars like it's nothing in that game. And that's what I love about that shit, right? Even Fire Emblem. Even though Fire Emblem has done me dirty on some occasions, I at least get something. I at least get pity broken. Genshin Impact, they'll pity break you with a fucking book.
Mondo wa jiyū no kuni. Riyue wa keiyaku no.
Shōgun-sama, kanojō ni wa kanjō ga hotondo naku, samasama na katachi de eien
toyū yū. You said Destiny Child Gang? No, that's another game I don't even want to touch because that game just makes me want to beat my meat all the fucking time. Like, I've never played a gacha game that makes me look down at my dick every time I boot this shit up and say, I'm sorry, little one. Like, what the fuck, dude?
人の願いが一定の強さに達した時、神の視線がその者に降り注ぐ。言い換えれば、神の目はその者の願いを代表している。シゾは、先に取り憑かれたのでしょうか。そういえば、彼は神の目を押し寄せたばかりでしたね。おかしいな。心の黒かっこいい。何か欠けているよ。神の目を奪われるというのは、願いを奪われることと同じじゃ。水に落ちた者のように、あがけばあがくほど暗く冷たき深海に落ち。
That's very pretty. That's very pretty. But you know what game looks better than this? Ghost of Tsushima!
この稲妻ではメガイレの成功により人々の願いが次々と踏みにじられています。このような状況を見て見ぬふりをしていては安心して眠ることすらできません。ここからは私が約束を果たす番です。ご指導をお願いいたします。
How you gonna release a character like this and then show us a flex? The guy wasn't even getting hurt when he was getting chopped up. My man was completely unfazed when she was slicing him. Look at him. So why am I like this? Hey, I loves me my titty bandage characters. You know me. Ever since Senran Kagura, I loves me my titty bandage characters. Like, sheesh, imagine taking that shit off, man. It's like opening up a Christmas present. Who the fuck is this and why is she so cute? She got a leaf on her head and a tanuki tail. Damn, there's a lot of content. This is a lot of content. Did she just pull a sword out her titty? That's a lot of content. Is this all free for Genshin, or is this something that's like you're gonna have to pay DLC for, like an enhancement or something? Cause I see a lot of shit happening. It's free? Wow. Wow, I sound like Brian right now. Wow. New era. Scarlet Nexus digital soundtrack. I could imagine the soundtrack is fire. Let me just listen to like a minute of it. The fuck is this? Is this me about to purchase shit? Hey man, welcome to the item shop. What do you need? Damn, these motherfuckers were in the studio. You could imagine them with their face mask on. They were just hitting that bitch. Nice. It's very groovy. Very groovy. Your dick was in your mom longer than your dad ever was. Damn. He's actually spitting. Hey, no, technically not, because your dick doesn't get developed because you're just a little cell.
Scarlet Nexus has a lot of nice music in its soundtrack. It honestly surprised me when I first booted up the game and heard the Fire Baby Spittin' Stro Jam.
Scarlet Nexus might be a game I'm gonna look out for, like, when it goes on sale. Because it looks like something fun to play. Also, I remember everyone in the chat was bitching about AI summoning files. I'm gonna continue playing like the Nuzlocke, and if I don't know, if I lose in the Nuzlocke, which there's a high probability some fuckery is gonna happen to me, I'm most likely gonna die to another Lillipup, like level 60, using takedown on all my fucking Pokemon and shit, and getting crits. What's this? Surprise that they're still doing the Olympics? Man, I don't give a fuck about the Olympics. He literally did a fireball jutsu, but no one cared. I think I've seen this clip before. People probably looked at him like, look at this weeb. Look at this weeaboo.
You ever get so bored that you start playing your PS3 for shits and giggles? That's me right now.
Your PS3? Sometimes I like to go back to old consoles like PS3 and then go into games that has multiplayer just to see who I connect with. And then when I connect with them, I just legit have a conversation. I'd be like, damn, man, I didn't expect to find anybody in here. And then they'd be like, yeah, man. I'd be like, yo, so what got you playing a PS3 right now at this time? Try doing that. I love doing that shit. You just hop onto chats and you just pop your mic on. You'd be like, who's alive in here? Who the fuck is here? Call of Duty lobbies, all that shit. And if somebody puts their mic on, you could just have a conversation. You can make a friendship. You said we should have full backward compatibility. That's true. Name all the game companies you recognize. All right. I recognize green. Is dead.
When you grow up,
be an influencer.
Huh?
Like and subscribe and ring that bell for notifications. Become part of the hype squad. This video is sponsored by Raid.
What do you want to do when you grow up?
He said Raycons.
This video is sponsored by Raid.
Oh, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends.
I'm losing my mind.
You don't have to heal, Shola.
What the fuck? What?
Hearts, but I'm losing my mind.
You don't have to heal, Shola, if he's already dead.
Donald, heal me!
Together! Nobody knew how healthy would be so complicated.
Nobody. Mickey Mouse and Kingdom Hearts.
Did somebody mention the door to darkness?
Like, I'm here to yuck and kick ass. I'm Gwarsh. I'm all done yucking. Put him up, pretty boy.
I'll admit, I'm a little overprotective.
Since when?
Revenge.
Delete this.
Delete your photo, then.
I will turn you into a moment and drop you back in your Aragorn so you can freeze to death.
Healing your party and helping with lucky emblems.
I see.
This might be a good spot
to find some ingredients.
This might be a good place. Yo, Donald's eyes, dude.
Might be a good spot
to find some ingredients. Real shit.
But I'm losing.
Yo, this might be a good spot. That used to fucking annoy me. This might be a good spot. Oh my gosh, it's loud. What he said?
It's summertime! You know what that means.
That was me yesterday.
On my toes. Hey yo, Bia. I just bent the block while these bitches wanna be ya. Probably cause my waist going money long near. Well, I ain't talking cars long here, don't care. In a twin seater, you tell Mara was Tia. Pissy pitsy, I fuck them like porn stars. I'm playing basketball, but my bitches is all stars. Da Vinci on my wrist cause I'm richer than most broads. Yo, Nick, these bitches trippin' and sendin' my postcard. I put on my jewelry just to go to the boat.
Nicki Minaj has nice teeth. What the fuck is this shit, dude?
Bruh.
Back at it again at Krispy Kreme's. Oh my god. That is very nice. Back at it again at Krispy Kreme's. Back at it again. Missile knows where it is.
The missile knows where it is at all times. It knows this because it knows where it isn't. By subtracting where it is from where it isn't, or where it isn't from where it is, whichever is greater, it obtains a difference or deviation. The guidance subsystem uses deviations to generate corrective commands to...
Nah, I ain't listening to this shit. I feel like I'm in school.
Hey, bro, watch your jet. Watch your jet, bro. Hey, bro, watch your jet. Watch your jet, bro. Hey, bro, watch...
Watch your jet. Vinland Saga, never heard of it.
Do me either.
Seen this.
This bitch levitates now!
Put your damn hand up! Where's your Nerf gun?
Have you seen me? I'm invisible!
This is a fucking A-Boss!
Bro, what are you doing up there?
There's no fall damage. Look!
Shit!
What?
Robin niggas? Ravinnega? Benigga Beast? Starfin' Equisha? Nigborn? Wait, you a nig...
What? It's just Cyborg.
Ayo, did you not see my Twitter post from the Pokemon stream?
From the Pokemon stream? What? Oh, I muted Kuba. I think you posted some crazy shit the other day and I had to mute your ass. Real talk, Kuba. There be days Kuba will post on and I'm like, I gotta mute her ass. What is this? If I unmute you, hold on. Wait, how do you unmute someone? Dearling, I gotta repost this shit. Guess I'll use takedown. Dearling, yeah, because you see, you weren't here in the last Nuzlocke. We went to the forest and there was a fucking Dearling, and the Dearling almost, I think, killed fucking Nathan or Yemster. Yemster almost died because the fucking Dearling out the blue. Like, mind you, none of these Pokemon used these moves before. But then randomly they just decide to be like, you know what? Let me use, like, some left pocket shit. Let me use takedown. You know what? Dearling is going to randomly come out of the woods and be like, judgment. Judgment has been dealt. You said, did you watch the state of play yesterday? No. Should we watch it? Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun. Takedown. Retro worst nightmare.
Takedown. Is it my worst nightmare? I feel like it's Bide. Yo, where are the Pikachu raids? I see no more Pikachu balloons around. At least give me a 100% Pikachu. Dun, 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 dun. You said nah, it was all indies. Some were cool, but not crazy hype. What's next on the Nintendo Switch? Bravely Default 2. Out now. Why you put all these games on this shit? It's already out. Completely delete everything here. Summer 2021. Mario Golf Super Rush. I hear the online is hot doo-doo butter. Outer Wilds, I don't give a fuck about this. Monster Hunter. I saw somebody playing the Monster Hunter stories. The art style in this Monster Hunter, I love a million times more than Monster Hunter Rise. Monster Hunter Rise has a bit more of a realistic approach, but the cartoony style and the way the colors pop in Monster Hunter stories just looks so pretty. I love the colors in this one. Dookie Dookie Literature, I've already played it. I was already mentally scarred. I don't want to go through that traumatic experience again. No More Heroes 3. Psh. I'm praying the game runs good. I feel like they're not talking about the game enough, which is kind of making me get scared. You know what I mean? Because it's like, if a game is about to come out and it's good, people usually talk about it and they usually like advertise it a lot. No More Heroes 3 has been kind of like in the shadows. They're like, hey, it's coming out. And then they just stay quiet. Like, it's coming out. They're hitting everyone with a Kibutsuji from fucking Demon Slayer. He's like, it's coming out. Then when it comes out, they promoted it a lot more in the spring. I wouldn't even say a lot more. Like, they kind of talked about it in the spring. Skyward Sword Zelda HD. I'm going to be real with y'all. I've already played this game before, but I don't mind replaying this game. I might get this game again and then stream it. But goddamn, $60 though? $60? It's not worth, right? And there's no point of even me saying, hey, let me wait for it to come out on sale. Thank you, Snowy, for the invite. I doubt that shit's even going to come out on sale. You know damn well it's going to be like, it's going to be like eons before it comes out on sale. For 60, it hurts, man. Me waiting for Twilight Princess HD Copium.
Me waiting for Twilight Princess HD Copium.
And then they got Ace Attorney. Oh, this is a much more HD image. The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. What the fuck is this? What's that? The World Ends With You. Psh, the Persona ripoff? Having cover arts in Shibuya when Persona invented Shibuya. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, Japan was like, fuck. Shibuya looks nice in Persona. Let's actually make it. That's the only reason why Shibuya is actually real now, because Persona did it. the Persona ripoff. Tony Hawk Pro Skater. Okay, The Legends of Mana. I gotta look at this game again. I think a lot of people were excited for this. Wario Get It Together. That's gonna be a day one cop. That's gonna be a day one cop, dude. Shibuya destroyed in Jujutsu Kaisen. You said I fucking hate you. Yo, okay, so Wario Get It Together is going to be a day one cop. Metroid Dread. Oh, shit, I'm about to sound like one of them people on Twitter. This shit looks like a, like, not even a 3DS game. This shit looks like a regular DS game. The one that came out, like, way back, the gray DS, that looked like a little tiny foldable lunchbox. Metroid Fusion for the Game Boy Advance looks better than this game. I said it. Hot take of the century. Metroid Fusion for the GBA looks better than Metroid Prime Dread. I said it. That it was a DS game. That was a Game Boy Advance game. What? Metroid Dread, Instacop, Stop the Cat. Based. Chat Malding. Okay, look, Metroid Dread, I might still get the game because I feel like it's going to be a good game overall. I can imagine, like, running through in the game, getting chased by those robots. It must be, like, anxiety-inducing. Like, my butt cheeks is going to be clenched the whole time I'm trying to run away from those. Sonic Colors Ultimate, I'm definitely getting, but not for the Switch. I'm getting it for the PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5, whatever. But I'm not getting it for the Switch. Diablo, I ain't touching that shit. Life is Strange. Life is Strange, True Colors. What is this? I mean, I played a little bit of Life is Strange before, but it was interesting. Hold on. Oh my god, this fucking Pikachu keeps going up and down. Please just get caught. Super Monkey Ball, Banana Mania. I'm gonna cop. I have a sweet spot for Super Monkey Ball. And I just want to see the monkey just go, wah, fall off the freaking stage. And I just want to hear the announcer yell out, fall out, wah. The monkey scream is just fucking hella funny. That alone just makes me want to cop this. Wario Get It Together, Metroid Dread, Sonic Colors. I never played, like I said, Sonic Colors, so I'm getting it for the PlayStation. Mario Party Superstars. Real talk, this shit should have just been an expansion for the Mario Party that was already out. This should have just been an expansion. I don't know why they're trying to charge us $60 again. They should have gave us like a $15 that we have to spend, and then we get like an expansion and maps. $15 or $20, right? It feels like a $20 DLC, and then they're like, yo, we're adding four more maps, way more mini games. I would have paid for that. But Nintendo was like, fuck you. You're going to have to pay $60 again for a completely other Mario Party. And they're throwing back. They're basically rehashing old Mario Party shits back into this game. And mind you, it's not even all the old Mario Party shits. They're only bringing back like four or five maps from like the previous Mario Parties, which is kind of stupid. Do you know how much old Mario Party maps there should be? Why don't they just release like a super big Mario Party game where they're like over 500 fucking mini games, bitch. 10 plus maps from all the previous old games. But Nintendo will never want to do that shit. You know why? Because they're going to milk the fuck out of this. Because guess what? Next year, they're going to release Mario Party Superstars 2 and then bring back old maps from Mario Party 1, 2, and 3, like the Spooky Forest and the other shits. They're going fucking abuse the fuck out that shit. But oh shit, let me join this thing. You said copping? I'm gonna cop Mario Party Superstars. You know why? Because I didn't even cop the other Mario Party. I didn't even cop the other Mario Party. Mario Party 3D All-Stars. Well, I don't think I made it. I did make it. GG's. Okay. Shin Megami Tensei 5. That's a day one cop. But I feel like this is going to be a day one cop for me. And then everyone in the chat's going to be like, play it on the hardest difficulty. Play it on the hardest difficulty. You guys are going to be out your damn mind. I am not playing this shit in the hardest difficulty. Next thing you notice, I'm going to run into a fucking Mott. Or I'm going to run into a goddamn, what's that shit called? Abaddon. Fucking Abaddon is going to be like in the spawn with his big ass mouth. Fucking Abaddon using goddamn Megidolon. Jack Frost. Shin Megami Tensei 5. But I'm definitely looking forward to this game. Even though I know it's not going to be like super crazy graphics because it's on the goddamn Switch. It is what it is. I'm going to tolerate it because if it looks anything like Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Because I like Xenoblade 2. Even though like the world was expansive in Xenoblade 2 and the graphics weren't the greatest. Xenoblade 2 still, I had a really good time with that game. Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. People were shitting on the game when it was announced. Ugh, the chibis look ugly. Can I get a pre-order for both copies, please? Like, them walking into GameStop still. This game looks like shit. Let me pre-order it right now. I don't like the chibi, but I'm still going to cop. Of course, man. And then it's like, I don't know. I feel like that game is going to be awesome. I'm really looking forward to Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. You know what, bro? What if I do, like, what if I cop this game and straight out the womb, I don't even play the game casually. Like, I play the game in Nuzlocke mode on stream. That would be fun as fuck. That would be fun as fuck, right? On stream? We do a Nuzlocke on this shit straight out the... Oh, I'm excited. That would be so fucking fun. Brilliant Diamond, straight out the womb, like Nuzlocke, and we're gonna play with Nuzlocke rules. Anything we encounter in the first route, we gotta catch it. We gotta use that Pokemon only. That's gonna be fun. You said people are doing that too? Yeah, because look, here's the thing. Remember when Sword and Shield came out? I'm not gonna lie to you. I could imagine it's very boring when you play it casually, where it's like you just catch whatever you want. You go through the adventure. I feel like it's boring that way because you can just always revive your Pokemon. There's no risk. There's no risk. Nuzlocke adds a lot more fear into bullshit. Bidoof gang? Hey. Nuzlocke Cynthia is a menace. Oh, I can imagine because Cynthia's first Pokemon is a fucking Spirit Tomb using Embargo straight out the womb. Straight out the womb. So you know a Pokemon's dying. When you go up against Cynthia, The second she starts the battle, fucking embargo with the goddamn... She's out for blood. Krikatoon gang. You said, what do you mean out the womb? Out the womb means like the game comes out and then I'm just going to straight up go to a Nuzlocke. Because usually my ass would have been like, let me complete the game and then let me start over a new file and then do a Nuzlocke. But when I get this game, I'm just going to go straight into a Nuzlocke. It's going to be a lot of fun. And I feel like it's going to make like a lot of funny content, a lot of funny moments. I'm going to be screaming my ass off, but I'm definitely going to get a Brilliant Diamond. Just Dance 2022. I'm not even going to lie to y'all. I bought Just Dance. I know you guys probably see me. I'm playing it sometimes on the Switch. It's very fun. Just Dance is very fun. Especially like if you have like friends over and you play Just Dance. I can't shit on this game. It's very fun. In before her spirit tomb has a move to kill fairies. Oof. Chimchar gang. Ooh, who am I gonna use? Chimchar, Piplup, or the tree? I'm gonna be real with y'all. I might choose Chimchar. I don't like Piplup at all. Piplup got a big ass head, and the tree is a tree. So fuck it. You said, or just for exercise? Yo, you could play Just Dance and you're exercising without realizing it. Like, I remember one day I was dancing to this one song, the Because I'm Happy song. He's like, clap along if you feel like something out the poop. And I was like, yo, I was sweating buckets. Danganronpa Decadence. I already played Danganronpa. There's no reason for me to hop back in this game. Even though there's probably like a new little side mode, a little side story shit. I'm not going to spend $50 to $60 just to replay Danganronpa. I feel like I've gotten the full experience of Danganronpa. I played all the games. I played the spinoff with what's his name? Ultra Despair Girls. I've watched the anime. I love Danganronpa. I have a deep love. You said it's sold separately. But is it worth even playing, though? If it's just like a little side doo-doo, you know? But did you play Danganronpa V2? Yes. No. Maybe so. Advance Wars 1 and 2. I played Advance Wars for the Game Boy Advance. It was pretty good. Fuck Advance Wars on 1 and 2. You know what they should have brought back? Golden Sun. I don't give a fuck about tanks and little army men. You should have brought back Golden Sun. But anyway, that's besides the point. I'll definitely probably cop Advance Wars 1 and 2 because this was a really good game for the Game Boy Advance as well. Splatty My Left Toon 3. Insta Day 1 cop. Pokemon Legends of Arceus, I don't know, man. I gotta see more gameplay of that, because I thought we were getting a Switch Pro. Apparently, we're not. So now, I know I'm gonna start seeing them 1 frame per second Chimchar fucking animations talking about. So, we ain't getting no Switch Pro. So, Chimchar's still gonna be moving like this. So we a little bit in trouble. Project Triangle. Okay, Bootleg Fire Emblem. And Mario Rabbids Sparks of Hope. I didn't even play the first Mario Rabbids. And I saw that game the other day was on sale, I think, for the Ultimate Edition for $10. And I didn't cop it because I forgot. Arceus is going to be goated or trash. It might be goated because I know Nintendo's not just going to release a shitty Pokemon game, you know? That sounded funny coming out of my mouth. Okay, Nintendo ain't going to release like a full-blown flop. Like, the game might be sucky in some portions, but it might still be a passable game, is what I'm trying to say. It might still be very passable. But yeah. I'm looking forward to this. Name all the companies you recognize. I recognize Umbrella Corp. Just Umbrella Corp.
Heyo, just wanted to link you another song from Scarlet Nexus that felt like chat would like to listen to.
You said what time I'm gonna end the stream? Probably around like 2. Probably around like 2 o'clock, yeah. This game got tunes. This game has tunes. Sounds great. I'm gonna let it run for 30 more seconds and then we're gonna keep going because time is limited. You said this is a Persona 5 ripoff? Yo, you actually spitting. Like, look, they look like Personas. They all have Joker's fit. And guess where they're at? They're in the fucking metaverse. This game is a fucking ripoff, dude. Wait, you guys said that there's a demo for this game? Where's my controller? Let me see. Yo, I remember I put up a post on Twitter. Right? The other day, I was using a sling bag, right? Like, you know, one of those crossbody bags where it's like, it goes here and then it just goes to my thing. Yo, ever since I started using this fucking sling bag, this side of my neck right here has been in fucking pain. And I'm like, yo, my neck hurts. Every time I wake up, my neck's like, ugh. I don't know, man. I'm in shambles right now. Can I transfer stuff from the demo to the full game? That's actually a good question. You said I played that shit 4 times. Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart still in the front. Scarlet Nexus is $60. Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut Game Bundle. Why I gotta spend $60? I have the game already, bitch. I have the game. $76? Bitch. Hold up, I'm looking for the Ghost of Tsushima shit. They're trying to charge me $70. Nah, they told me if I got the PS4 version, I'm good. All right, hold on. I think I found it. Ghost of Tsushima Director Cut Upgrade. To play this game on PS5, your system may need to... Okay, updated. Although this game is playable on PS5, some features may... Okay. Wait, it's $20 for the upgrade? Is this what I have to pay for? This shit right here, right? Hold on. This shit, right? The Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut Upgrade. Wait, but is this the upgrade with the DLC? Alright, hold on. Cause that game, I can't wait to, you know, like, honestly speaking, I got like the full experience playing Ghost of Tsushima. And to replay it, I'm not even mad at it. Like, I'm dying to replay this fucking game. Anybody who has a PlayStation, if you haven't played Ghost of Tsushima yet, you're nuts. You're nuts. That game is so fucking good. Like, I got so invested into the world that I was in, and it's so big. And, like, literally almost on base PS4, no load times. No load times. Like, I'm riding my horse, and I'm waiting for the frames to dip. I'm waiting for shit to go wrong. I'm waiting to hear the fucking PlayStation turn into a goddamn fighter jet. Nothing. No issues. Okay, that is the upgrade, if I already bought it. All right, let me find the Scarlet Nexus game.